desperate to see the kingdom of God break into our lives.
We
cry out to you with all
mean to be in the world but not of the world. Jesus said in Luke chapter 11, verse 33, no one, when he has lit a lamp, puts it in a secret place or under a basket, but on a lampstand, that those who come in may see the lights. We're called to be salt and lights. So we are to let our light shine, but Jesus goes on, the lamp of the body is the eye. Now you notice on those monkeys, one of them's covering his eye. The world will say, well, that's just for monkeys. Monkeys are foolish. You know, see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil. But Jesus clearly tells us, watch what goes in your eye. Be very careful, guard what you allow to come into your eye. The lamp of the body is the eye. Therefore, when your eye is good, your whole body is also full of light. But when your eye is bad, your body also is full of darkness. Therefore, take heed, be careful, that the light which is in you is not darkness. If then your whole body is full of light, having no dark parts, the whole body will be full of light, as when the bright shining of a lamp gives you light. So that tells us that Christians are meant to be full of light. We're crucified with Christ. My life is no longer my own. I've been bought with a price. God has put His message in me. I'm not speaking my message anymore. I'm living His message. The gospel is a message that's meant to be lived 24/7 by consecrated worshipers. Everywhere we go, we are to be the breathing, living incarnation of the message of the gospel. That's what Christians are to do. That's what we're called to do. Jesus said, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every nation. How do we preach it? Do we just repeat the words, the information of the gospel? Yes, we do that. Because the Bible says if the gospel is hidden, it's hidden from those who are perishing. But at the same time, it's not just something we repeat as information. It's something that we are to live with our lives. You know, far too long we've tried to be silent witnesses to our generation. It's time for us to live the gospel, but to speak it out from the inside. It's to be so permeating through us as light that it can't help but be revealed. You can't hide it when it's real. That's how we are to be immersed, not first immersed in the culture, but immersed in the gospel. We're meant to be immersed in the light of God. Otherwise, everything else is just hype. People are searching for an identity. They're searching for the truth. Well, they're searching for something. Searching for something that's going to fill the void. But so much of it, sadly, is just hype. What we need is to be filled with the light of Christ so that some, not all, sadly, not all are saved, but God's not willing that anybody should perish, but some will respond to that message. But it's Christ in you. And what I'm asking you is, are you willing to be that salt and light? Are you willing to give your body to God? Are you willing to give your heart, your soul, your mind to God? Are you willing to become a disciple of Christ and cut off, circumcise your heart, cut away the things that are not just hype, but that are poison, because not everything is good for us. Jesus said, be careful that the light in you is not darkness.